Previously on Zelling Zatara, we fall in love with the Exumas, snorkeling at Thunderball Grotto, diving in Hawksbill Key, we feed the iguanas at Allen's Key, and of course, see the swimming pigs, but then become a little homesick at Thanksgiving.
Yes.
Quit whining.
You're taking all of it.
Shut up. Yeah,
don't hold it.
So much love.
Thanksgiving!
Yeah, woo! Love in the air.
So we finally met up with some other cruisers while we were in Georgetown.
This is Ronnie and Jane from the Ghibli?
Ghibli.
Yeah.
Ghibli.
But it could be Ghibli. It's Thanksgiving Ghibli.
Ghiblet, there you go.
Ghibli, gravy.
We're trying to figure out when to leave Georgetown. We've been here way too long.
Yep, time to get out.
Yep. So we have left Georgetown. Today's Saturday, and we finally found maybe a window of weather to leave. And we got our jack lines tied on. So when the weather gets rough, we can tie onto the line with our life jacket and not fall off. All right, come back, Finn. That's a good example. Anna's on water maker duty now. Every time we turn on the generator and we don't have other things to run, or if we do have things to run, Keith just filled up the air compressors.
You mean the tanks?
I mean the tanks, and so we have started making water again.
Can you shut the door?
Seems like we go through how much? Well, we emptied a tank. We have three tanks, and they are how many gallons each a tank? 85 tanks. We've used an entire tank in, what, 2 days?
I guess so. I don't know what happened.
I don't know. We either have a leak.
Normally we don't get down below half.
Or everybody's just taking too long showers or something.
It's level.
I know. It's just weird.
I know. It's like we're trying to be level.
I guess a gimbal stove really does work. Although I'm not cooking right now, they're just sitting there. That is weird.
It looks like it's on a tip.
It looks like it's gonna slide right off, but we're the ones sliding off, aren't we, Kate? The window. How are you enjoying water duty?
Fabulous.
Fabulous. It's like the most exciting thing in the world, isn't it? We met up with Ronnie and Jane from Ghibli in Rum Cay and explored the little island town. And we just enjoyed the realization that we've really become cruisers. I mean, our life has really and truly changed. Our goal on this journey was to break out of that suburban bubble that we've been living in. And even though we've just started, I can already feel the change in myself and see it in my kids. We've had our ups and downs, and we've sacrificed so many modern conveniences to do this trip, but the rewards have been worth every one of them. And you know, we've learned so much, and I know we have so much more to learn, but I truly wouldn't change a thing so far.
So we're fixing to start our trip from Rum Cay down the DR. We've got a good weather window. We're just gonna plot a rum line in, and we're on the leading edge of front coming down off of the coast of Georgia. So we're going to try to get around, get through here and just make it to the DR in the next 48 hours. All right, so what are you doing, Mom?
I am preparing sandwiches so that I won't have to do that while we're rocking and rolling. And I'm going to make some noodles.
For dinner?
Yeah, so that all we got to do is microwave them and throw some sauce on them. And because I'm kind of nervous about this little long trip, overnighter.
Kate, what do you think?
About what?
This long 48-hour sail.
What's going to happen or what it's been?
What's going to happen. Overnight, all day, every day for the next 2 or 3 days.
I'm going to play on the phones and I'm going to sit and I might be hungry. So we have PB&J stuff up there in the cabin. Locker, so we won't have to come down here.
Okay, Finn, are you ready for the big sail?
Yeah, I just don't like the waves.
I love watching the waves hitting us.
It'll be big.
So we've got the seas are going to be 5 to 10 feet today. Probably more like 10, but they're diminishing tomorrow. So we're going to suffer a little bit today to get farther south. Boat's ready. We've got everything dinghied up, tied up, everything's secure. It's just a matter of going now. Hope it goes good.
So we left Rum Cay and we are just before the weather window, so it could be hairy.
Swelly. But it's smooth, it's not too bad.
But you said without the motor we're going 3 knots?
Without the motor, speed over ground is 3 knots.
Yeah, but we're not.
It's going to take us 48 hours to get to Rum Cay at this speed.
We just left Rum Cay.
My iguana.
Yeah, so
my iguana.
Turn.
My iguana. Sandwich time number 2. Now it's PB&J's. We had ham and cheese for lunch, and now it's early dinner, I guess. We are listening to the Trolls soundtrack from my 15-year-old daughter. Yeah. I really don't know what to say about that.
Afternoon. We got about 15 hours left. We're still having the motor sail a little bit, waiting for the winds to veer. The seas are calming down, and looks like it's going to be a nice night sail, although we're just going to be motor sailing. We're still going too much to windward. The winds are south of east. We need them to veer about 10 to 15 more degrees, and we'll have a nice reach down to Mayaguana, and then on down to the DR. Well, that's it.
Yeah, so get your caffeine on.
Yeah, we got 48 hours of sailing.
Oh, goody. I'm excited.
Well, the day is almost over. It's 5 o'clock. Sun is setting. Mind those clouds. Might be a few squalls tonight. This is our first overnight. The seas are calming down. Winds are kind of calming down. We're under sail now since 4:30. It's 5 o'clock now. And we've been sailing without the motor, which is so, so nice. Everybody's kind of in a pattern. Renee made us some... What do we eat, Renee? What was that called we ate? Yeah, Alfredo pasta, and I put some Marie Sharp's hot sauce on it. It's really good. She did a good job. Kids are adapting well. It's kind of exciting. It's cooling off. Night's coming on. Be a nice night. Stop in Maya. I should be in Mayaguana by 8 or 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. I hope we don't have to turn on the motor. So, talk to y'all in a little bit.
So right now, it seems really late, but it is only, 6:22. I don't think you can see that. And we have 14 hours to our destination. We're at a heading of 136, and it is dark as night. Gonna be a long night. Most of the kids are still up, actually. I don't know how this is gonna turn out because it's nighttime. You might not be able to see any people, but this is our first night run. We're going from Rum Cay to Mayaguana. And everything's going really good. It's kind of creepy out here.
We just passed through, I don't know, some little keys there, Plana Keys, and we're in the Mayaguana Passage now. We still have about 3 or 4 hours to go to get there, but at least the sun is up and I'm awake. I just got on my ship at 4. Keith went to sleep. His ship was from noon to, midnight to 4. And so this waking up at 4 o'clock and taking over is kind of tough. I'm really tired, but I gotta make sure I stand up and stay moving and stay awake. While ago, I started to doze off here. My head hit the steering wheel and I woke up. I'm embarrassed and stupid. Anyway, I don't know if this light helps you see me or not, but we're doing good. We still have about, we should get there at 8:30. We have 3.5 hours to destination. It's pretty rolly all night, rained quite a bit, but we didn't have any trouble with any of it. Everything went really smooth.
Poor Keith, as soon as the sun came up and he had been off shift for about 2 hours, the jib furling line decided to just break apart. It was so frayed. The sound of the flapping jib woke him up. And so luckily he's a hoarder of all things and had plenty of extra lines to rerun that furling line. it got jack up and they completely removed the old line, reran the entire jib line. And I'm just thankful that it was daylight and it was calm seas. And you know, I've been watching other YouTubers and what they go through, and I am very so aware that we ain't seen nothing yet. That is for sure.
So it's lunchtime. Those sandwiches I worked so hard to prepare, coming in handy.
The next 2 days were basically uneventful. We were all just really tired, and it was just nonstop sailing. However, the four of us, me, Keith, Jack, and Anna, took 3-hour shifts each so that everyone got to be at the helm for a bit and still get time to rest and relax.
Okay, so this is our second night on the water of night sailing. Last night we went from Rum Cay to Mayaguana. We didn't even stay overnight in Mayaguana. Or did we? I don't even remember. But it's about 7 o'clock p.m. and we just took off again to head down south past Turks and Caicos all the way to the DR. And night sailing is kind of peaceful. You can look at the stars and relax. There's no other boats around. And, I get first watch of the evening. I'll sit here till probably midnight. Keith is asleep because he didn't sleep hardly at all yesterday. We had jib furler problems right when he woke up, right when the sun came up. And so anyway, it'll be a long night. I don't really mind night sailing. It's peaceful, the kids are sleeping. Actually, Anna's up here. She's on watch with me. She was hanging out reading a book. So, it's all good. So, I don't know if you can tell, but our wind speed just picked up a little bit. Apparent wind speed is 16.9, so we're going 7 knots now on our 147 heading. And so we're making pretty good time. All right, we're pulling into a new country.
Dominican Republic, we're here.
It's been three hard days of sailing.
Not hard, but it's been three overnights.
It's been three long days of sailing. And this is the place we have never seen before.
Mountains. Did you know the highest mountain in the Caribbean is here?
Yeah, I read that. Yeah, it's taller than the mountains right there on Mount Baldy. Mount Baldy's only 7,000, the one here is 10.
I can't even begin to express the gratification, the success, the joy of getting just at least this far. Our little family of six has traveled over 600 miles by sea in just 1 month of our lives so far, and we still have a long way to go. But the satisfaction knowing that our team did this, that we accomplished this together, is just incredible. Join us next time as I about have a nervous breakdown navigating the streets of the DR. And ironically, we take the kids to see animals in captivity at Ocean World.